just want to shine like the sun when it comes up from the city, from the rooftops. Cause today's gonna be my day. I just want to climb to the top of a mountain, standing tall when I'm howling. Cause today's gonna be my day, it's gonna be my days, 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 days. Good night stress, see you in the morning. Oh no, I don't gotta guess, you're always there for me. Oh yo, sowing them seeds of doubt, I think you like seeing me freak out. Good night stress, see you in the morning.
Oh yo, wake up, I get out of bed, stay up. Stay out of my head, cause it's dangerous, and I don't wanna lose my mind.
Thank you so much. We are so glad to see all of you here today. We are For Good Measure. We are a community a cappella group based right here in Ann Arbor, Michigan. And we are really excited for the concert that we have prepared for all of you. So thank you so much for coming out to see us. That last song is by Fits and the Tantrums. I arranged that after Jordan came to the group with the next song we're about to sing. And I just love those two songs together. I feel like they go together like avocado and toast. But that's just probably my millennial showing, sorry. Anyway, I'm going to hand this off to Emily Gunderson to introduce the next song.
Hello. So I was just scrolling through Facebook one time randomly, and I came across this video where Andy Grammer, who wrote this song that we're about to see next, spoke a self-love poem. And so this is the poem that he wrote. So step one is to realize that you've been trying too hard. Step two is being cool with just letting down your guard. Step three is to agree that not everyone's gonna like you. Step four is coming to terms. That's just something you've got to fight through. Step five is a deep dive below who you think you're supposed to be. Step six is to identify the areas in which you do not agree. Then step seven is to feel the tension that authenticity often brings. Step eight is to be okay if no one listens while you sing. Step 9 is when you find your sense of self and are at peace. And step 10 is when you genuinely believe there's no one else you'd rather be. And without an ounce of irony, you let these 7 words slip free. Damn, it feels good to be me.
Nothing worse than being thirsty, am I right? So, this next song is I don't even know how to like properly introduce this song because I've been wanting to do it for over 10 years. This is a song that I first saw performed by the King Singers in choir during my choir class. We watched their whole entire concert, and we are not going to be on their level, but you know, you just can't beat them anyway. But this song is by the British rock group Queen, and it's very silly, and I've been dreaming about doing this since I was in my like way too like glittery, glitzy, pretty dresses a cappella group in high school, and now I finally get to be with my proper weirdos who will let me do this. So sit back, relax, and enjoy a seaside rendezvous.
Seaside, whenever you stray. This time of year, it's so fashionable.
Our next song is from, it's called Somewhere. It's a choral version of Somewhere. It's from the musical West Side Story. Many of you may know it. And if you don't, I'll give you a little recap. It's basically Romeo and Juliet, so it's a tragedy where two star-crossed lovers fall in love despite the odds and the hate that they're raised with. So Romeo and Juliet were from Montague and Capulet, the two houses, and they were taught to hate each other from birth, and yet they fell in love. So love transcended this hate that they were taught. And the same thing is true in this musical, except that instead of it being two households, it's actually two ethnicities. And so we have the Puerto Ricans who are moving up to New York to have a better life, and the American, there's an American New York boys gang, and they fight each other. The hate has been embedded in what they have learned, and yet the protagonists learn to love each other and transcend that, yet hate tries to destroy them. So this is a musical about that. It's a song about those star-crossed lovers. And one last thing, I didn't know this, but Stephen Sondheim wrote the lyrics. He died last year. He left an indelible mark on musical theater, and so this is a great way to see what amazing transformative lyrics that he was able to also bring in addition to the amazing songs that he also composed. Also, one more thing, I'm going to shout out to my mom. My mom, I love you. But she also made sure that I watched a ton of musical theater, knew great songs. Anyway, it's about the musical. Anyway, she made sure I got to see amazing things, and I love the music that she made me see, and inevitably, during amazing songs like God on High from Les Mis, or even Oh Holy Night when the Christmas songs come on, she turns to me and says, this one's my favorite, and this is one of her favorites too, so I hope we do well, Mom.
Let's do it in this key. we doing? Are we ready for some emotional whiplash? For those of you that don't know, this one in the middle over there and I got married last year. We're actually about to celebrate our 1 year. And this song, this next song, made its debut at our wedding. It's called Hooked on a Feeling, and I hope you all enjoy.
Ooga chaka, ooga 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 chaka, ooga 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 chaka, ooga 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 chaka, ooga 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 chaka.
I can't stop this feeling,
ooga ooga,
deep inside of me.
Ooga chaka, ooga ooga.
Girl, you just don't realize what you do to me.
Ooga 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 chaka, ooga.
When you hold me in your arms so tight, you let me know everything's all right. Hooked on a feeling. I'm high on believing that you're in love with me.
Lips as sweet as candy. Tasting on my mind. Girl, you got me thirsty for another.
Some more emotional whiplash. So this song we started working on at our retreat last year, and I think Rachel was a good example of sometimes you cry when you're least expecting it.
What?
Who the thunk? That's never happened to me before. Certainly not on a porch swing near the lake in Pentwater at our annual retreat singing this song. I think this is a really beautiful song and arrangement. It was originally written by Billy Joel and is really about courage to be vulnerable and what that looks like when you know grief is possible. So enjoy, and so it goes.
In every heart there is a room, a sanctuary safe and strong to heal the until a new one comes along. I spoke to you in cautious tones. You answered me with no pretense, and still I feel I said too much. My silence is my self-defense.
And every time I felt a rose, it seems I only felt the thorns. And so it grows.
And now for something completely different.
Thank you. time to do the things we never had. While dogs cry out in the night, as they grow restless, longing for some solitary company. I know that I must do what's right, sure as Kilimanjaro rises like Olympus above the Serenity. I seek to cure what's deep inside, frightened of this thing that I've become.
Oh. And now we make our transition from being sad to being angsty and angry for this portion of the concert. Our next song is by the darling of pop a cappella, Mika, or at least it was when I started in like 2009, everybody was doing Mika. But nobody, as far as I can tell, has done this song, which is called Promised Land. It is semi-autobiographical. Mika was born in Beirut, and his family fled the war in Lebanon when he was just a year old and grew up living in a very religious family in France. And so I think this song has a little bit of angst from that time in his life. So please enjoy Promised Land.
I was born in that summer when the sun didn't shine. I was given a name that doesn't feel like it's mine. Lived my life as that good boy I was told I should be. Prayed every night to a religion that was chosen for me.
Sold my soul, broke my bones, tell me what did I get? Did my time, told the lie, ain't seen anything yet. Strike me down to the ground, make it hurt, I'll eat the dirt, I just don't care anymore.
How could you break my heart? Already played my part. I keep my promise, man. Show me the promise, man. Don't have to buy my time. Give me the ground I own. Never you told me how. Look at me now. I got no money in my pocket and the whole world's bringing me down.
Kept on running from the devil, but the devil was you. Every time I see the light, I'm falling deeper in debt. If I never see the good, how could it come to an end?
Sold my soul, broke my bones, tell me what did I get? Did my time, told the lie, didn't see anything yet. Strike me down to the ground, you know I've seen it before. Make it hurt, I'll eat the dirt, I just don't care anymore.
Now going from angst to heartbreak, this next song is called Mess You Made by indie pop band Michelle. And they're fronted by, written and performed by four girls in their early 20-somethings living in New York City. And who better to know heartbreak than four young 20-something-year-old girls living in New York City. So this is my first arrangement, and that was very exciting for me. So it's...
When I think about the things that I hasn't gone on for so long, I admit. Last summer vacation,
I was a bitch!
Thought we'd be better by now. Home is a circus, but just on the surface, I'm putting that family love back on the shelf. Home is a circus, I'm done feeling worthless, I'm giving it up cause
I can't, I don't, I won't cry anymore.
Thank you so much for that. And thanks again for being here. We've had so much fun. Well, we've had a lot of fun. We also had a lot of heartbreak, a lot of angst, a lot of anger, but also a lot of joy. So thank you. Thank you for being here. Thank you for coming on this journey with us. We've got one more song, two more, maybe. I don't know. We'll see. We'll see if you're feeling it. That was just a little hint. So for our last song, we're taking it back. So last time we performed here in First Presbyterian, we decided to do a mega mashup about our pop punk music. So this is music that was a very core for us millennials in this group, because that is when there's the music that was key in our middle school years, our high school years, when angst is running high. And so for coming back to First Presbyterian, we wanted to do another mega mashup. This time, we're going more for that nostalgic feel. And so we're going to do a song that is a very classic choral piece. It was written by the very, very famous classic choral composers, LMFAO.
Bullet.
sing it the flow.
Let's sing it now.
Show the girl low, 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 low.
Swim.